3 million students take advanced placement exams every year, spanning 38 different courses. Students can sign up for those AP classes for the 2020-21 school year now. Now, completing AP courses can send students to the top of the class before they get to college. Admission officers do like to see the students who show initiative to learn and take those challenging courses. Joining us now is AP Vice President Terry Redican. Terry, thanks so much for joining us. It's great that we're getting the word out now for these AP available courses. So what are the benefits to high school students for taking these college level AP courses?
Yeah, thanks for having me, Dan. The benefits of AP are real. Students can earn credit that save them time and money in college. And college admissions officers, they tell us they're looking for students who challenge themselves by taking courses like AP. In fact, our research shows that all students who take AP exams, regardless of score, are more likely to enroll in a four-year college and more likely to return for that second year, staying on track for that college degree.
Yeah, and how does a student decide which AP course to take?
Yeah, we have a tool to help with that process. It's called AP Potential. Students can look at their SAT score report or their PSAT score report, and it shows, based on a student's strengths, which of the 38 AP courses might be the best fit for them. For example, if they score well in the math section, it might show an increased potential for AP Statistics or AP Physics or one of the other AP STEM courses. AP Potential matches AP courses not only to a student's strengths, but also to potential college majors that a student might have interest in. So it's a great tool to use for conversations with your counselor, with your teachers, with parents, as you're trying to figure out your course schedule for next year.
And how can those students get college credit by taking AP?
Yeah, nearly all U.S. colleges and universities grant credit and placement for qualifying AP scores. Those are scores of 3, 4, or 5. When a student earns credit, they can send their scores anywhere. By contrast, some other credit-granting programs may not transfer to so many different colleges. And beyond the thousands of college-specific credit policies, there are now 31 states that have policies that guarantee a student will receive the college credit by earning a score of 3 or higher on an AP exam.
Harry, there are some newer AP courses now, right?
Yes, we've got some exciting new AP courses. We've got Computer Science Principles, which introduces students to the foundational concepts of computer science. It includes some coding, but it's not only coding. Students do hands-on projects that introduce them to how computer science applies to so many exciting potential career opportunities out there, like app development, 3D animation, robotics, and more. We also have AP Capstone, which is a two-course sequence. It has AP Seminar, and then the second course is AP Research. They're skills-based courses where teachers help students select a topic of interest to them, and they work on projects throughout the school year where they practice college-level research skills, presentation skills, and more.
All right, that's Terry Redican, Vice President for AP. It's good information that students should have now to apply for those AP courses for the next school year. Terry, thanks so much for being with us. Have a great day.